What's going on, everybody? It is Tuesday, 2:30. Mastermind through tough times. Every week, we got a great show for you. We're going to start it off with a little jam session. Sets the theme, you know what I'm saying, for our show today. We're going to be talking about pandemic weight gain. Did you gain your quarantine 15? Let's talk about it today. Let's jam out. This is a perfect time for you guys to like, share, and comment. We have a great giveaway for you guys today. We're going to get a facial from Margaret Harrison and Mary Kay. We appreciate her today for sure. Make sure you like, share, and comment so you can get in on that drawing today at the end of the show. Go ahead and get it out to all your friends. If you're with us today, let us know that you're here. Leave us a comment. Just say hey, show some love. Hey. I see you, Mike. You gonna work it out. But I still mess with a big girl. You ain't fit, girl. I still hit, girl. What? You brought two friends. Okay, three more now. Hop in the bed, four door. Do you know the difference? Make sure you like, share, and comment. We come here every Tuesday at 2:30 for Mastermind to Tough Times. Make sure you like, share, and comment to get in the drawing at the end of the show for a facial sponsored by Miss Margaret Harrison with Mary Kay. Hey. Come on, if you're with us today, go ahead and show us some love. Make sure you leave us a comment. Make sure you like, share, so you can get in on the drone.
Hey, my name is Jill.
We have a great topic for you today. We're going to talk about the pandemic weight gain. I see you, Margaret. I don't know how much I gained. I see Kanye trying to get us to work out.
My name is Ellen May from Mobile, Alabama. And I just want to say, since listening to Kanye's workout tape,
we got a great show for you guys today, man. We're going to be talking about the pandemic weight gain. Yo, did you gain the quarantine 15? What's your number? You 15 with a 20 with a 45? We're going to talk about it today. Hey. Let's work it out. We come to you live every Tuesday at 2:30, Mastermind through Tough Times. We have a little jam session before we get started on the topic today. Did you gain the quarantine 15? What was your workout plan?
Ladies and gentlemen, allow myself to introduce myself. This time around,
make sure you like, share, and comment. We have a great drawing at the end of the show. Come on. Come on, let's get some of that weight off, that quarantine weight off today.
Okay, great.
Yeah. I see you doing those push-ups, Mike. Come on, put that clap in between it. Come on. We come to you live every Tuesday at 2:30 for Mastermind through Tough Times. We're going to talk about. Let me correct that. Pandemic weight gain. Did you gain the quarantine 15? Make sure you like, share, and comment. We have a sponsor at the end of the show. Margaret Harrison is going to be giving away a facial. Yes, yes, yes. You know we had to jam it out. Mike, how you feeling? Oh, yeah. Yes.
What up?
I love it, man.
Welcome to the Mastermind Through Tough Times.
Yes, thank yes. Y'all
ready with the workout music because we're going to be talking about shedding them COVID pounds, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. So it's like the freshman 15 when you go to college, you put on that weight.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, it's like we've been in college for the last 8 months. Mm-hmm. That what y'all saying? Right.
Definitely. Between that, what else you get the where you don't want to do anything in your senior year?
The itis? Oh, yeah. Senioritis?
Yeah, senioritis. Okay. Yep, that's it.
That's what's up. Anyway, I am your host, Michael G. Davis. Welcome to the Mastermind Through Tough Times. I got my crew here with me. On my right, we got Margaret.
Hey, y'all. I am Margaret, also known as Mystique, because as Mystique often does, she blends into the background, and when she pop out, it's all over for you. So that's who I am when it comes to negotiation. When I in the background, I come out, it's a wrap.
It's a wrap. You winning every time. And we got Jess in the booth with the representing the Mastermind Through Tough Times, jamming with y'all today.
Definitely, man. It's always a pleasure. It's your Keep It Realtor, J. Joseph, a.k.a. X-Ray, getting down to your real estate needs. I see what you can't see, man.
Absolutely. And I am Professor X, because when I get through with you, man, you're going to be
game over.
You're gonna be ready. You're going to be powerful, right? I'm going to teach you how to, I'm going to train you on how you work with them special powers that you got when I peel back them layers. So you can have that real estate power and that prowess in this bad boy. All right. So if you're checking out the Mastermind Through Tough Times this is your first time being here. This is where we come together. And it's kind of like shop talk, right? You go to the barbershop, you go to the beauty shop, and, you know, y'all be talking about everything. Matter of fact, before we started, me and Margaret was talking about Lovecraft Country. I mean, yeah. You just never know. So that's what we do. We felt like as real estate professionals, we come in with shop talk with a twist, with a realtor twist. That's what it is. Shop talk with a realtor twist. All right. So one of the first segments that we do is our trending topics. So let's go ahead and jump into that. Margaret, what you got for us on Twitter?
So trending. The number one trending topic on Twitter I have on my end is cyberpunk.
Oh, no, that ain't what Jess got.
Yeah, so Jess has something different. Hers is number two.
Number two.
Okay.
So cyberpunk 2077 has been delayed. Yeah. Now, what is cyberpunk?
Apparently, it looks like a video game that's been adapted to a movie starring Keanu Reeves.
Oh, So... Okay. Well, I'm not a gamer.
Yeah, me.
So, next. if you are a gamer, drop us a line.
Yeah, apparently people like it. They into it. Okay.
Well, you know, these video games, man, they like billion-dollar industries. These and like a single game series, like Call of Duty, that thing make billions of dollars.
And Grand Theft Auto.
Yep. Billions.
Yeah. Okay, so trending at number two, I have K-pop. Hashtag
BTS.
Oh, okay. I don't listen to K-pop, so I wouldn't know too much.
That's
about
that Korean group, ain't it?
Yeah. I guess that's why they call it Korean
pop.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it says armies are responding to BTS postcards that ask what makes them the happiest in their lives. Wow. Okay, for real.
Why'd they say armies, though? Like, for real, for
I guess
real,
throngs and multitudes of people.
B. So postcards. So their new album is B. B.
Okay.
Like Beyonce?
No, because like Beyonce, it would be B-E-Y.
B.
Yeah, so I don't understand. I mean, but they like BTS, I guess. So.
I don't know. I don't know nothing about them.
All right.
I saw them on Saturday Night Live, though.
Were they talented?
I mean, just like any other pop
artist. Did they have some bangers?
I mean, on Saturday Night Live, you only sing two songs.
But I would think they would come with their bangers.
Now, I can't recall if they were speaking English.
Okay. Did it make you get up out your seat?
No, girl.
Like
no,
the Power up. Theme song did me the other day.
Man,
did it make you get up?
Look, we ain't finna give 50 no love, man. 50 hugs.
All right. Oh, he tried to backtrack. But, you know, sometimes you have to separate the talent from the person.
That ain't what I'm talking about. I'm talking about how he did us on YouTube. Copywriters.
Oh, okay. That's what you're talking about. Oh, okay. Well, he gave us some love on Facebook.
Yeah, he did. Appreciate you.
Right. Okay, so
what's next?
Next, gaming again on my end.
Cyberpunk again.
Yes. All right,
keep going. Trump lost our jobs. They're doing a hashtag Trump lost our jobs.
Yes.
Click on that one.
Is it worth it?
Yeah.
We finna bring the people
down. Let's see Trump lost our jobs, Jess. There it is. Click on it. I will bring back the jobs. What's he talking about?
Lost 1,800 factory jobs.
26 million. Trump is responsible for the worst economy since the Great Depression. Well, I mean, COVID kind of has something to do with that.
You know what? But there was a plan for COVID.
What was
there
the
was
plan?
A plan in place. He got rid of that cabinet. So he is.
So he on that, that's on him too, huh?
Mm-hmm. Because all of this has been foreseen.
Well, that's why. Yeah, we should have.
It was
been.
Not planned. You want? They weren't ready.
Well, that's why Obama was trying to get us into renewable energy, because that's kind of where there's no denying the fact that hashtag Trump lost our jobs.
Mm.
Mm. And he's the guy that ran on the promise of jobs, jobs, and jobs.
Nice.
Well, that's going to be your new president.
Is that going to be the old president? Because he already the president.
He is, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
So we need some more pick-me-ups. Okay, so I ain't messing with number 5. It's about soccer. Y'all know about soccer?
Nope.
Okay, so trending number 6, Blake Shelton.
Oh, they're engaged?
Apparently.
Ain't they on The Voice together?
Yes, maybe that's where, you know, love connections are made.
The Voice.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for saving my 2020 and the rest of my life. Blake Shelton and Gwen Stefani. That's an interesting combination, Margaret.
You think so?
Oh, look at John Legend. Congratulations. I bet he's singing.
Well,
amazing,
you know what?
News.
It goes together because he's a country singer, right?
Yeah.
With roots in rhythm and blues. She's a...
Like alternative rock?
She had a song that was... Sound very much like some rhythm and blues at bananas. This is bananas.
B-A-N-A-N-A-S.
So music.
It's bananas.
I think
they match.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't gonna last though. Celebrity marriages never last. She did. What did you say? She didn't know what? She didn't know Blake Shelton existed before she joined The Voice. Oh, it was up to The Voice.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, matchmaking. The Voice is bringing love into 2020.
Mm-hmm. So, moving on.
So you think The Voice has one of those, you know how some companies have those policies to where you can't date at work? So now one of them got to leave.
I don't think they have it because they've been dating.
Oh, they were?
Yeah, they've been dating.
Oh,
for
now
a
they
while.
Just don't get married.
Yeah.
All right. Let's go.
Number 7, Dashoween.
What's that?
Dashoween.
Hashtag Dashoween.
So, I mean, Dad Halloweens?
Oh, DoorDash.
Oh, okay. Oh my gosh. Thank you, DoorDash. And
Go Fuji.
For this gift. Okay.
So it's trending because DoorDash is sending out gifts.
No better way to celebrate.
Go Fuji and at DoorDash. So okay. DoorDash is sending candy to people?
Yeah, so like trick-or-treating, I guess. So they're sending the candy to the people.
Dashoween.
Yeah, they sending Halloween candy.
How do they determine who they send it to?
I don't know. Thanks for the box of treats for Halloween.
Hashtag Dashoween.
Maybe they're sending it to just their random customers.
That's a pretty good marketing.
I think that's cute.
Marketing plan.
I think us as realtors, we might need to try.
Oh, there it is, right there. It's a Dash and Win giveaway. We're bringing Halloween to you. Want to win surprise from a contest candy store? Retweet us your favorite Halloween sweet with hashtag Dash and Win plus hashtag giveaway for a chance to win a spooky treat. Oh, so it's a contest.
Yes, I think that would be good for us.
For realtor tip?
Yes, all right, like for what we trying to do.
What you mean?
In City Park. It might have to be for next year, though.
Oh, okay. Margaret then took us on a different direction. Ain't that meeting.
So that's cute.
That is cute.
Okay, so vote them out. That's number 8. But I'm interested in this Saved by the Bell reboot.
What? Number 9?
Yes.
Saved by the Bell reboot.
And they have gotten older, y'all. So it's a new crop of kids, but with some of the same old actors.
Are they the teachers?
They're the teachers. And I'm guessing AC has to be the coach because what else would he be besides the coach?
When I'm working in the morning and it's something I come back on it and it
in the morning. Should they change the theme song?
To what? Look at that.
I don't know.
Oh, that's the teacher. He's still there.
Okay. Oh, that's his son. That looks computer generated or something. Like, because his son looks just like him. But I don't think that's his son.
Oh, that's the creator of 30 Rock. Why they ain't bring the black girl back?
Lark, she's been having some mental problems.
Oh,
I don't know if that's fair for me to put her business out on the street.
Somebody, you found it out from somebody.
Yeah, I did.
All right. Well, Twitter gave us a little bit today.
Yeah.
Thank you, Twitter, because last week
it was dry.
Man, Twitter was killing us last week, bro.
Dry, dry.
But that Saved by the Bell, man. I remember when Saved by the Bell came out, man. That's one of them shows that used to make me get up real early on Saturday morning.
We should have that up as one of our themes. It was so
It didn't make the cut. Yeah, it didn't make the cut last week.
Yeah, it wasn't a banger.
But we're not going back because we're going forward. So, the pandemic wave.
Okay, yes.
How does it happen?
I don't know if it's like the stress of the situation, all of the uncertainty.
Mm-hmm.
I found myself at the drive-thru. It was like, okay, I was like, man, give me some of them fries. And
so
yeah, give me some more than fries.
Comfort eating.
Yeah, I think it was a lot of comfort eating. And the lines were really long at the beginning. Mm-hmm. So it was like, when I get to the front of that line, I'm getting what I want. Times out here, we don't know what's going on.
The discipline was out the window.
Yeah, people out here catching it. They don't know who can catch it at the time. Mm-hmm. Only old people catching it. Black people catching it. Who catching it? No, black people can't catch it. Okay.
Young folks can't catch it.
Yeah,
can't catch it again.
We didn't know what was going on. So when I got to the front of the line, I was like, "What? I need to be happy.
I need to be happy.
Give me all the fries.
All of them. I'm a super size.
I want all the fries and the cinnamon sticks.
So how you going to get it off of you now?
Okay. So getting it off.
Because clearly y'all can see that I didn't have them problems.
Well, I'm a very magnetic person, so everything's attracted to me, including fat.
Everything.
Everything. So that's okay.
That's okay.
What am I now? I'm still a little scared about the gyms.
Okay.
So, but I said, you know what, I'm going to have to. So I
hit the gym?
Yeah. So what I did, I went to a smaller boutique gym.
Oh.
As opposed to my big 24-hour fitness
gym.
Yeah,
but I would think that you go to the bigger gym, you got more space, you could do more social distancing in a small, compact gym.
I'm thinking of the people who went through that gym, the amount of people who's going through the 24-hour fitness. Would they touch? Did they touch this?
But they disinfecting it.
That's what they say.
You don't
but at the smaller boutique gym, I can see all them people. I know they don't have thousands of people coming through the doors every day.
All right, so you're at the small boutique gym.
Yes.
And how's that going, Margaret?
It's going well. I stopped being sore. So I've been at it for like 2 weeks.
Okay.
So I'm not sore now, but I know once I go up in weights, I'm going to be sore again.
Maybe. You just got to how often do you work out?
The goal is supposed to be 4 times a week.
You got to give your body time to read and to rest.
Mm-hmm. It's been rested. Playtime is over. Yeah, my body didn't rest.
So you have a goal.
I have a goal.
Now, is the goal to get rid of just the 20, or are you trying to get rid of?
I have a goal to get rid of 60.
60 pounds. Now, you know you done said it to everybody, so now everybody know what you're trying.
People don't know me.
They're going to hold your calendar.
I don't know them people.
You don't know who watching.
I don't know them. They ain't going to hold me accountable. But I do want to drop 60. So if holding me accountable helps, okay.
How'd you come up with that number?
I came up with that number because I think back in my days, my yonder years, that particular weight was when I was living my best life.
Okay.
And I'm sure I got some more best life coming, so yeah. I just gotta get it all right. Down. Yes.
All right. Okay. Yes. I ain't mad at you. So yeah, man. I don't know, but you know, I was getting in that work. You know, we going to Cancun, so I got to get my Cancun body right.
Oh, when y'all going to Cancun?
Next month.
Oh, wow. Well, shoot, Mexico letting us in.
They the only ones. That's why we all, that's why somebody was like, why is everybody going to Mexico? Because that's the only country that let us come.
Yeah, and they say, we got y'all next year. We sending everybody, all of our people to you.
Man.
So y'all get rid of that damn wall or whatever y'all got going.
What wall? That big fence?
Yeah, the big fence. I heard like in one of the winds, some of it blew down.
It's ridiculous. Oh, well. Y'all better go vote.
Yes. I'm sure everybody already voted who's looking at us.
You think so?
We have a very smart audience out there. I know they've already
voted. But you know, people could get busy and they could get, you know, turned around.
Yeah, it's, you know how you can drive up in the line and get some fries? Yeah. You can drive up in the line and go vote. Now that blew my mind when I saw that.
I know. Because I went and got the little finger condom.
Yeah, me
when
too.
I went to go vote, put it on your finger, make sure you touch the buttons. And a little disinfected wipe.
Yeah. So whoever came up with that, they made a killing.
With the finger condom?
Yes.
I wonder what the real name of it is.
Should we ask Siri?
She don't know. She don't know nothing.
All right.
So real estate topics. Now, Jess, you had to participate in this one, girl, because you know about them stocks and stuff.
Mm-hmm. My role.
I'm here.
The question asker. And right. Professor X's role is going to be the one disseminating the information.
Absolutely. So REITs stands for Real Estate Investment Trust, right? So now we're all kind of familiar with mutual funds.
Yeah.
Right? You familiar with mutual funds, aren't you?
Right, yes.
And stocks and things like that. Because, Jess, that's something that you're really into, right?
Let the people know what you're into. Definitely. That's something outside of real estate that I've really been drawn to, especially it was highlighted, especially during the pandemic. You know, in March, things went down. So yep. I just wanted to kind of learn more about that. And something that I continued to hear about were the REITs. And I thought that would be interesting to just bring up to kind of learn more and educate ourselves, even myself, more on it.
Absolutely. From a real estate space. So, correct. You know, for you all that are not familiar with what a REIT is. In essence, what it is like, you know, people take their money and they invest in stocks, and stocks are just shares of a company, right? And then as your investment, based on the kind of stock that you got, you're entitled to a return on that investment based on how the company performs, based on its profitability, that determines the share price and things like that. So the shares can be traded, or you can just purchase stock within the company.
Right.
Well, REITs is pretty, it's the same thing. The difference is instead of you getting a piece of a company, you're getting a piece of a real estate portfolio, or you're getting a piece of a company that is purchasing a lot of real estate inventory. And then they're using your money to make those acquisitions.
Okay, so say, you know, you come across a lot of people that say, well, I want to get into real estate. I want to do this. I'm going to get into some real estate.
I want to be an investor.
Would that be a good avenue for them to go in if they don't know anything about acquiring properties and flipping and rehabbing? Would a REIT be something for someone who says, I want to do some real estate?
Well, I think it would be good. Yeah, because you're coming in on the more passive side of real estate.
Right. More hands off.
Yeah, you're more hands off. And because, you know, you would want to get familiar with kind of the strategy that is for that particular REIT. You want to see what their strategy is. So you might want to educate yourself on, you know, what kind of properties they're buying. And, you know, and all of this was prompted from the article that we read about the black hedge fund.
Right, I'm going to pull that up.
The REIT. Yeah, so just going to pull that up. So all of this kind of spawned from us reading the article where we saw that there's the first REIT that was going to be, their strategy was going to be based on affordable housing products. So, you know, if that's the direction as an investor that a person is going to want to go, then they definitely would want to educate themselves on what that strategy is. Because most REITs, they do a lot of investing as it relates to like these large real estate development places.
Oh, like a strip mall, like, or something?
Well, like Meyerland, like kind of
not,
development.
Not the strip mall, but
right.
Entire
complex. Okay. Like Gulfgate, like that entire complex. Gulfgate. A lot of times that's REIT funded. So that's how they raise the money to do those kind of large developments.
Huh.
Yeah. So to see somebody come in and they're basing it off of affordable housing, mm-hmm. right? Which is still would be multifamily, right? But they're just going for multifamily properties that are tax credit properties. So they can only charge a certain amount for the rent in their complexes for them to be able to qualify for that.
So that's just another avenue to get into real estate investing.
Absolutely. Okay. So Jess, tell us a little bit about this article.
So I just found it interesting, as I have set alerts to be notified about things that are going on within the market, and just different articles that popped up into my email about a Black-owned, same Black-owned firms to launch the first affordable housing REIT, which you touched on. So these two gentlemen here, I believe McFarland, he's out of California. Some investors have come together to create this REIT that would focus specifically on affordable housing. Their portfolio, I guess, would be set up of those investment properties that specifically deal with that.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah, so that's kind of what sparked this. And we thought it'd be a pretty good topic for us to share during our shop talk with a real estate tweet. Yep.
Now, when Jeff first brought this to us, I could have sworn she was saying REITs, like a Christmas wreath. It's a real estate wreath. I'm like, well, I guess that'd be cute, like a wreath with some little
house. Real estate wreath.
No, that's not what we were talking about.
No,
we was trying to put Margaret on.
So indeed.
Now what a wreath is.
I do understand what a wreath is. It's a
great
real estate
Investment trust.
Well, there's an I in there we're missing.
Investment.
Okay,
real estate investment trust.
There's an E we're missing.
Estate.
Or okay. Estate.
Real estate investment estate.
You trust. It's okay. You're visual.
Real mm-hmm. estate is not one word. Real estate is
yeah,
two
you
words.
Got the R, the E, the I, and the T. There we go. It's all right. I just got to sell the houses. So
there you go. Look, you hands on, okay?
I just got to sell them houses.
Definitely. That was fun.
And keeping that in mind, I have a realtor tip for everybody.
Oh, what you got
awesome.
For me?
Talk
today,
about
CRM.
Aura?
Aura? Yeah. I know it's R, but I like saying R because that's how Jesse Jackson pronounces R. It's not always thought that was cute.
C-R-A-M. Jesse, now you know that's not a word.
So that is customer relation management.
That's right.
CRM. So when you have a few customers, you still need to maintain them.
That's true.
When you have a plethora of customers, it's more important that you maintain them and keep track of everyone because you want to give good, excellent customer service.
So what do you do with a CRM?
So a CRM helps categorize your clientele.
Right.
It lets you know when someone's birthdays are coming. Mm-hmm. It's a way to keep track of that so you can reach out and touch them. Mm-hmm. Lets you know when maybe it's time for them to file for their homestead exemptions.
Okay.
Lets you reach out and touch them.
So it helps with contact management.
Contact management. It helps with that.
Contact management system.
Contact management system.
Customer management system.
Client management system. Mm-hmm. And relationship could also take the place of that.
CRM.
That's customer relationship management system.
Mm-hmm.
So it's relationships.
So managing, like knowing when the birthdays are. I mean, I think it also is good for capturing notes, like when you're following up with people, just kind of see what was the last conversation that we had.
Yeah, so there are a lot of different CRMs.
Yeah.
There are some real down, dirty, low budget ones.
There's some free ones.
That are free. Very much like a Excel spreadsheet.
Mm-hmm. Now, I think everybody should start with an Excel spreadsheet.
Right. Start with Excel.
You know, when you first get into real estate, your focus should be about touches. Right?
Yes.
Going out there, trying to identify who has a real estate need, who needs something, who need to lease a house, who need to get their credit fixed, who want to buy a house, who want to sell a house, who just is thinking right now, it's on their brain, something real estate wise that maybe you can assist. And now, I don't care if it's right now or if it's 6 months or if it's in 12 months. If somebody's thinking about real estate, they want to do some real estate.
They need to be thinking about you.
So you need to capture those people, capture their contact information, and you need to begin dating them.
Yes, because at first, you know, I would put it in my head.
Mm-hmm. And how was that working for you?
It worked out fine when I only had like two people I was chasing. But when it's time to, when you want to date multiple
20,
30, people.
40, 50.
Yeah, how those people who out there just... Mm. Out there doing it, and out there in them streets, dating everybody.
They need a black book.
They need a CRM to keep everybody straight, because you want to know birthdays.
You want to know birthdays.
Okay, I'm supposed to call so and so at this time because they get off at this.
So why do we do all of that?
To make my life easier.
That's true. But really, I guess to build the relationship, to nurture.
Yes, to nurture, build that relationship. And because people work with people that they like. And that they trust.
Yep.
That they know.
Yep.
So how are you going to get to know, like, and trust someone if you don't contact them, if you don't reach out and touch them?
Really get to know them.
Yes.
And you know, that strategy of trying to keep everything in the brain, I don't think that's an effective strategy.
No, it's not effective because it could drive you crazy, especially when you're trying to ramp up your business.
Yeah.
So you can't keep all those people in your head.
So if you don't have a CRM, now don't worry. Look, it took me 8 years to get to see. I was in real estate 8 years before I got a CRM. And I was just using a good old Excel spreadsheet because I love spreadsheets. Using a good old spreadsheet. Mm-hmm. But once I got the CRM and uploaded, like now we got 15,000 people in our CRM.
Yes.
Brooks and Dave. That's a lot of people trying to keep in the head.
Yeah. It's better in that CRM than in your head.
Yeah. Yeah. You can manage more people. All right. Well, good tip.
Yes.
Oh, look at Tanya. Tanya, where you been, girl?
Hey, Tanya.
Look, she say I'm dating real estate.
Girl, we haven't seen you in a month.
Where you been, girl? I told you we hired you. You're supposed to be on every Tuesday. Girl, you better cut it out. All right, Mark, what's going on?
Yeah, so we have a giveaway. The giveaway is, now I am the queen of side hustle. So one of my side hustles is Mary Kay. So I'm also that Mary Kay lady, and Christmas is coming up, everybody. We got a lot of stuff out there.
What about Thanksgiving? Check out that site. In October. You know what? I'm gonna digress a little bit.
Okay.
I'm gonna let you come back.
Gotcha.
So I was taking my kid to school today, right?
Mm-hmm.
And on the radio, we was listening to KSBJ, mm-hmm. and they was talking about Christmas stuff. Mm-hmm. And my baby was like, "Why are they talking about Christmas and it's Halloween?
It's time to make that change."
that's what my baby said. And you know what? I didn't even know answer for the baby. I was just like, "That's just how it is, Mama."
It's time. My friend posted on Facebook, she's like, "Okay, yeah, I'm ready for Christmas to come through so we can go ahead and get 2020 over, because right after Christmas, you know, you have a new year, you know, we flip it and it's time to start
again." That's what we said about 2020. You don't know what's waiting for you in 2021. So COVID didn't show up till March.
Things is looking up.
So I'm sorry about that.
Y'all get to win this very luxurious spa treatment. So we have one every Saturday morning at 9. So y'all wake up early. So if you happen to be lucky enough to win this, you will get a facial peel. You'll get a lot of hydration. We got something for the bags under your eyes. If COVID has been keeping you up, you've been up all night eating. We got.
Got to work it out.
Yes. So we got all this stuff that detoxifies the skin too. A lot of people don't know. With COVID and these masks, we having a lot of impurities hitting our skin. So we got something.
Yeah, called bad breath.
Oh, wow. Okay. So we don't have nothing for bad breath. So you might just need to get a toothpaste, get some a toothbrush, some mints, or something like that.
You breathing your own madness.
Yeah, so the lucky winner is going to win this luxurious face mask. And when y'all win it, I would like for y'all to come back and tell us how it was.
Oh, yes, let's go.
Like, comment, and share.
I just, who going to win today?
Who's going to win? Where you go, Jess?
She there. She in the background.
Okay. I'm in the background. We making some things happen. I started to kind of get caught. I was about to go through your page here.
You were. Look,
I got distracted.
She got caught. She got pulled in. Just got pulled in.
Pulled in. But no, I think that is a great giveaway for those who did like, share, and comment. You definitely have an opportunity to win this marvelous gift from Margaret Harrison, Mary Kay. I'm going to pull up the wheel. All I need is a drum roll for my people. Uh-oh. We're going to get it going.
Spin that quick. Is it spinning?
What we got?
Oh, my favorite agent.
Awesome. Congratulations, Laquana.
Spirit fingers.
Yes, now Laquana's going to need some to herself time Saturday morning.
Some to herself. Is this Saturday?
No, because I'll have to mail her the products.
Virtual.
Yes, virtual. So she's going to be on there with a lot of other people doing a hydrofacial. So she's gonna need some to herself time.
I'll see what I can do.
Okay.
Ain't no guarantee.
All right.
All right. So next week.
Trying to help you out, LaQuana.
Next week, what are we talking about?
We're talking about our favorite movies. Now, I don't know. Should it be like Halloween themed movies or just all time favorite movies?
Good question. Let's surprise them.
Okay, so favorite movies, y'all.
But you know what? Halloween will be. We'll be in November.
Oh, it don't matter.
It'll be any movie then. That's been settled.
Yes, old school movies, some iconic stuff.
Yeah, give us what your favorite movies are. Yes. So y'all come back next week and y'all let us know what keep you in front of that silver screen, wasting your lives away.
And it's a lot of good movies coming out, but I don't know who's going to the movie theater.
I know, right? Because I'm on that one Tenet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm.
I wanted to see I that. See no, that too. I'm not sitting in no movie theater in clothes like
you're
that.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go see it.
Oh, well, you tell me about it.
I will. Anyway,
I'm not ready. Sorry, y'all. I got a lot to say. I am not ready to pay $20 or $30 to see the movie at home either. Okay.
Me neither.
Okay.
All right. With that being said. Thank you, everybody, for showing up for our mastermind through tough times. It's good to see Tanya back. I don't know where she been. Talking about what had happened was. What had happened was nothing. Anyway, you was missed, girl. That's all we're saying.
We did miss you.
But with that being said, look, we had a great time today kind of talking through, you know, that quarantine. So y'all keep getting y'all workout on. Get it off your body, right? We know Margaret says she's going for 60. Let's hit it, because that was that size where she was living her best life.
Yeah.
So we want to see what that is again.
Yes.
So I'm Michael G. Davis, a.k.a. Professor X. The way I get in, I peel back them layers on your brain so we can get you to a point to where you can realize your real estate superpowers. Always join with my girl on my right.
I am Margaret, also known as Mystique, because when it comes to negotiating, I come in real nice, soft, and sweet. Then I flip on them and be like, none of that. And we show out here showing these people who these tough times are.
Absolutely.
Us, we tougher than them.
We doing it.
Because we out here making the money.
Cash money. All right, and I'm gonna throw it over to my girl Jess in the back. She's in the background as always.
Caught that thing, yeah. It's been good. It's been awesome, man. I love it, guys. Man, love the energy. We come here every Tuesday at 2:30. Mastermind through tough times. It's your Keep It Realtor, Jay Joseph, aka X-Ray, getting down to your real estate needs. I see what you can't see. We're gonna get this thing going. We'll see you next week. Y'all have a good one. Take care, y'all. Have a good one.